Are you ready for some autumn magic? Grab your paints and something to paint on, and we'll do this beginner lesson together. Hello and welcome to Deliberately Creative. I'm Stephanie and we're going to work on an autumn landscape. Beautiful, magical colors. I'm really excited for fall, and I hope you are too. Let's get started on what materials we're using. I have a 9x12 canvas panel. This is just one of the Arteza canvas panels. I have an assortment of brushes. I've got the number one ultimate varnish brush to put in our soft background. I have a 1-inch Zen Royal and Langnickel. Yeah, 1-inch. I have a monogram liner by Silver. It's the Ruby Satin. I have a 1/2-inch angle. Some assorted sponges. Leaves go in better, I think, even more natural looking with a sponge. So we're gonna get started. I'm gonna take the big varnish brush. This is like a giant mop. It's a 1-inch mop. And we are going to get it wet, kind of dry it out a little bit. I'm taking some ultramarine and some phthalo blue. Oh, colors! You want the colors? This is cadmium yellow, yellow ochre, cadmium red medium, ultramarine, phthalo blue, burnt sienna, raw umber, and two plops of just plain white. And I'm going to grab some of that white with my blue because I want this to just be a soft kind of washed in background. It does not have to be thick. It does not have to completely cover everything solid. It's going in softly. I'm going to grab more paint as I go. You do not need the exact same paints that I am using. You don't need the same colors that I'm using. You can use whatever you have to create a fun painting. Now I've got this set up a little bit differently, so it might have a bit of a glare. So now I'm going to go like this and just brush lightly across, smoothing it out. And now as I'm getting down here to the bottom, because really you're not going to see much of this at all. This is all in the background, but it gets us paint on the surface for more paint to stick to. I'm actually going to grab a little bit of this yellow ochre and just mix it with what's on my brush. And it's going to give me kind of a murky green. I'm going to rinse out my brush, dry this, and I'll be right back. This is mostly dry. Now we're going to go in and next layer. So we've done layer one, which is the background, the sky, basically, and the dirt ground. Next, we're going to put in the very background, yellowy leaves. I'm gonna go in and put that in using the 1-inch brush. I just tapped it in some water. I went and grabbed some shop towels so I could dry that off. I'm going to take that yellow ochre and maybe that just a tiny touch of ultramarine and phthalo blue. Phthalo blue will make a more of a yellow green. Lighten that up. Grab a little bit of yellow cadmium yellow. See, I'm just mixing the colors until I get what looks, ooh, that looks good. I'm going to go in and we're just gonna see random strokes back and forth, up and down, doesn't matter. You go, whoa, this is such a mess. What Does she even know what she's doing? Maybe. I might know what I'm doing. I might have an idea. Just sort of getting this on here. If your lines, if your brush is starting to give you like really hard lines, put a little bit more water on it. And again, I'm not worried about making this perfect. This is that sort of murky middle ground. See, it doesn't really look that much different when I pick it up. I'm doing from about here to about here. So I'm cropping. I'm going to make this just sort of work out the way I want it. I'm going to grab just a bit of white, making kind of this, sort of this foggy, whitish color, mixing it right in on the canvas. It's been a long time since I've done a actual real acrylic painting. Yeah, it's been a long time since I've done a real acrylic painting. I've been doing a lot more gouache lately. So now I'm looking at this going, I want some of that cad red and yellow ochre and a touch of, that's going to make a nice orangey color. Nice and bright orangey color. I'm starting to see a couple little pops of that kind of orangey color down in here. Like that. And a few pops of it are going to be like over this way. This is background stuff, guys. Again, don't stress about it. This is just going into the background. I think I'm going to actually make a bit of the, mix a bit of the phthalo blue and the yellow, cadmium yellow. And this is a cad yellow medium with a tiny touch of burnt sienna. The red in the burnt sienna will knock that green back so it doesn't look quite so carnival-y colored. Looks a little more natural. I'm going to use this brush, though, I think, to create some of the tree trunks in the background. I need to dry it again, and I'll be right back. Some of this is still a little bit wet, but something that I notice is that I think I do want to take just a touch of white. Just a touch. This white is not my favorite white. That's why I'm not telling you about it. And a little bit of the phthalo blue. Oops, not that much. Boom. Lots more white. And there's actually a little bit of this yellow ochre that got in here, so it's softened it up some. I want to lighten up that sky up here just a bit. And you're going, oh no, but you're painting over everything. It's okay. This is just going to be going in the background. Don't worry. And I am not painting in super thick layers. I am painting in thin layers and just letting it do its thing. I am going to take some of this burnt sienna, touch of water in it, a little bit of this white. I don't care if it's got a bit of blue. It's okay. Kind of making it a sort of pale whitish brown. Maybe mix it in with a little bit. Ooh, that looks good. Mix it in with a little bit of the raw umber. So now I am going to start up here at the top. My brush is all the way up on its edge. And we are going to come down and just press all the way off the edge. I like that. I like that color mix. A little bit of white. Don't press as hard, you'll get narrow ones. You want to press hard enough to get your paint to go down on the canvas though. So it's a balancing act. If you go too fast, your brush can't deposit the paint. So, if it starts skipping, you're probably a couple different things. You need a little bit more water on your paint to soften it up, or you need to slow down. Don't just go zooming across. I like how not mixing the paint on my brush is giving me those variations though. Okay. I'm just going to drop one along here. All right. That's good enough. I'm going to take burnt sienna and burnt umber and put up on my... very, very tippy edge. We're just starting to build a few little branchy bits. Whoops. Remember, branches off of a trunk are smaller than the trunk. But since this is all getting layered up, it doesn't really matter. I have a bunch of sponges right here. And I'm thinking for this back layer, let's see, get my sponge wet, wring it out. I'm going to get some brown into that green. Let's see what I get. This is kind of shadowy bits. I'm trying to just look and see what's the shape. I need more green. Let's just go boombity boom. Oh yeah. See that brown on there and the burnt and the yellow ochre. You know, don't do this if you feel that you don't like getting your fingers messy. This does... ooh, I'm getting all kinds of colors mixed into this. So there's going to be some random shots of other color in here. Oh, there we go. Oh, I like that red in that. just sort of working it across. We're going to put our first layer of orange leaves. I'm going to grab a different sponge and mix up a little bit of orange. So I'm taking some clean water, a blob of yellow, the cad yellow, a blob of cad red. Mix, mix, mix. Ooh, that's looking nice. Makes a lovely orangey color. Oh, I didn't get my sponge slightly damp. There. Sponge is slightly damp. I'm just going to paint this on. I'm going to put a little bit of yellow on here too, separate. First time, I will just, oh, don't leave the brush in the water. Bright orange. There's some bright orange over here. There's a bit of bright orange down here. I'm going to take a little bit more down here. I'm just going to make another little puddle of orange paint, yellow and red. Get that paint scraped out. I will go back to my brush in just a second. See, it's another layer of color. It's a slightly different tone. You don't need to have them mixed to match. You don't have to match the previous color. This is something to be aware of and to keep track of. You don't have to mix those the same. I have to dry this, and then we are going to put the dark tree trunks on. I was going to put a little magic in here. Gotta have a little magic. So the magic that I'm going to put in here is I'm going to use a little bit of zinc white. If I can, I can get it open. A little bit of zinc white. And I'm going to put a couple little like sun rays or light rays, sunbeams coming through. Sun's on this side, so I'm going to come this way. Starting up here at this top point, top corner, and I'm going to just come down, and I'm going to come down, and I'm going to come down, and you're going to go, ooh, oh no, what did you do? Now I'm going to soften this out, rinse my brush. Kind of run it up and down. Oops. So that's what we're gonna do. Do a little bit of magic. It's not in the picture. Or not in the reference. It doesn't have to be. Now I'm going to take that same brush. I'm going to go ahead and get the raw umber and burnt sienna. And I'm not adding white to them. And now, big tree right here. I'm going to press and smush. And if I have to press and smoosh again, this lovely texture along the edges, leave it, let it dry. It just adds to the effect of tree bark. And pretty much make your solid 1-2 pass. And don't mess with it too much. Okay, and now there are tree trunk or tree branches and stuff like that coming through here. Just remember, branches have to be narrower than the trunk they are attached to. I'm going to put just a touch of black out, I think. And we're just going to go and put some little texture. Just some little texture, not a ton. It's starting to look a little bit like an autumn forest, isn't it? All right, rang out my sponge. I'm going to mix up some more of that nice bright orange. And I'm not mixing it completely. You see there? Looks like ketchup and mustard kind of mixed together on the plate for your corn dog. Get that paint off of the brush. Okay, so we've got it loosely mixed and it's on here. So we're gonna go. Oh, that is so pretty. That is. Kind of like wherever you put branches, you want to put that bright orange. You don't want to press your sponge down too hard. Oh, that's lovely. Some twiggly bits, and then we're done. And I think I'm just going to use the burnt umber. All right, what do you think? Is this a painting that you would do? Do you feel that you are going to be able to do this with no problems? Because I think you're going to be able to do this with no problems. I want to see your artwork. If you do this, please tag me at Deliberately Creative on Facebook and Instagram, and I will show it some love. I hope that you will go out and do something creative. Take care of yourself so you can take care of those around you. I want to see you back here again really soon. Bye-bye.